You think you're so fancy with your flashy abracadoodle, don't you? Fat, who needs you? Ah, I caught a blow too many from those card-playing fatheads up on the ramparts. I got myself a golden ticket. I didn't even get the chance to use it. Why don't you take it? If they offer you a round of cards, this one guarantees you a win. It's called the Sparkler. Whoever's got it gets the pot. Filched it from that hog, Griff, himself. Careful, though. If you ain't as skilled a fighter as me, you'll end up on Dr. Lest's table with the rest of the lilies.
Close. I could see the light. I could almost feel her touch again. You ruined it. You ruined it!
Read the Reaper for me.
You there! What the devil are you doing without your collar? No harm. I've heard that before. Right before a sorcerer blasted a hole through my partner. This way. We'll get a new collar on you soon enough.
I should find a way out of this mess before someone comes to replace my collar.
think you're so fancy with your flashy abracadabra.
Why don't you take...
She groans in pain.
Leave me. Go.
She smiles and reaches out.
Sorry. I almost forget. I can't. Can't wait to. Leave me. Go. Get away. Get back.
She groans in pain.
Leave me. Go. No. Don't you dare. I want to be done. I won't let the Reds let them take me.
Is it not enough that you travel with me? Must you speak too? Go on then, bark away.
Leave me. Go. You leave me.
She groaned.
Leave me. Go.
The woman watches you leave through rheumy eyes. She groans.
I was so close. I could see the light. I could almost feel her touch again. You ruined it.
Thank you.
She looks at you with wet eyes and manages a wink before returning to her work.
Good to see you. You take care. Where's the oil?
Stay back. Stay back. Keep that monster Bedmast away from me.
This round.
What of it? Yeah, what of it?
Ah, grab it in your gobblers, the both of you.
If you don't like the game, Topsy, you can fold.
No, no. Just because the pair of you are filthy, cheating liars don't mean I can't beat you.
A little respect for Griff's right hand, Topsy girl. That's it. I call court. Pay up. Looky, looky here, mates. A fresh face. We love fresh faces, don't we? Oh, yes, we do. Why don't you join us in a round of cards? First hands on the house. Chuff to you, Chief. Here are your cards. You're up first.
You glance at your hand. Two purple monarchs. A hard hand to beat.
Quite the hand, Freshy. Unfortunately, two is less than five, and that's how many purples I've got. I reckon that makes me the winner. I'll be having your fee then. I'm sure the Reds told you. No one gets along without paying the interment fee. So, let's make this easy. Empty your pockets. Now, why would I go and do a thing like that, Freshy? I don't owe you nothing. Ugh, take a hike, then. I don't need your pocket lint. And by the by, you ought to find Griff in the kitchen. He's always looking for more of our kind to get in on what's good to get. Back for more, Freshy Fresh? Let me guess. You came across a bit of gold and want to turn it into a bit more. Pleasure, Chief.
Bottletop deals a hand, and each player glances at their cards. You have a lolly and two great hands. Not bad. Slug lays down two pink birds and a grimly. Bottletop folds. Ralvo sets down a set of four purple monarchs. That's one more than normally come in a deck. He's a dirty cheat. Again. Ralvo's eyes linger on the table, where the card lies as innocent as a piece of cardboard can be. His gaze travels up your torso to meet your eyes.
Now, where do you get a thing like that, mate?
Ralvo counts out the entirety of the table's pot without breaking eye contact.
Go! Hope you're behaving yourself, Frick.
Huh? What are you doing here? Thought Griff had you making the rounds inside. Lucky you. See you later, Christoph.
What are you after, Pipsqueak? Complain to Griff if you don't like it. See how long you keep your ears stuck to your head.
Thank you.
That's your fifth blue jester this round.
What of it?
Yeah, what of it? Ah, grab it in your gobblers, the both of you.
If you don't like the game, Topsy, you can fold.
No, no. Just because the pair of you are filthy, cheating liars don't mean I can't beat you.
He hasn't changed a bit. Always.
A little respect for Griff's right hand,
Topsy. Lest the void overtake and devour us all.
Right hand, my winker. Fella's got more right hands than an octopus.
That's it. I call court. Pay up.
Watching. That's your fifth blue jester this round. That's your fifth blue jester this round.
Greetings, child. I find myself in your so-called divine lands, yet I feel his absence deep in my heart all the same. He may feel like an inmate here, but you and your captors are the same stuff in race and customs, if not heart. You'll see what a difference that can make. Go well, my child.
Lest the void overtake and devour us all.
Irma, where are you, darling?
Pipe down, Farah. It's time to accept reality.
A little respect to Griff's right hand,
Topsy, please. I can't wait all day. There, Lizard. I'm looking for an inmate. A smallish man, thick spectacles, prone to somewhat eccentric chatter. He wears a large bronze pendant with a dragon stamped into it. Have you seen him? None of your business, inmate. Find me if you hear of a Migo. Otherwise, don't waste my time. You there! What the devil are you doing without your collar? Prefer a cage, do you? No skin off my nose. I've got the perfect cell for you. So you'd rather die here? Don't disturb me. Irma!
Farah, she ain't coming back. It's time to accept reality.
I don't think I ain't watching. That's your fifth blue chest to this road.
None of your business, inmate.